the Porta Nuova, or the central train station in downtown Turin, Italy. This is the transportation hub in the northern part of the country. And here you can catch the bullet train or the Freccia Rocca and be in downtown Rome in 4 hours. You know, train travel in Europe is all about timing and getting where you need to be. For figure skater Patrick Chen, he knows where he wants to be. That's at the top of the world. And in the post-Olympic rush, his timing might be just right.
Whirlwind in Torino. Japan's Daisuke Takahashi brings big tricks to the Palabella and credentials as an Olympic medalist. Meantime, Canada's Patrick Chan clocks in as a contender for gold. Eyes wide open for boy wonder. But what about Brian Joubert of France? USA's Jeremy Abbott can deliver. So can Japan's Nobunari Oda. Time ticking in Turin. This is Championship Figure Skating on CBC, presented by Artistry. The 100th anniversary edition of the World Championships from the old city of Turin, and the venue is the Palavella, Palace of Sails, which played host to both figure skating and short track speed skating at the 2006 Olympic Games. Hi, everybody. Welcome inside the building. Scott Russell, along with Olympic medalist Tracy Wilson and four-time world champion Kurt Browning. You know, there's an interesting dynamic at a world championship following an Olympic Games. You have established stars, yes, but fresh hope, new faces, and I don't know, something special might happen at a world championships like this. I remember 1988, Budapest, Hungary, a certain Kurt Browning and a certain quad that was landed.
Yeah, you had to say the year, did you? You really had to? That was because I had an opportunity. I wasn't fighting for the podium, to make a statement without the pressure of worrying about that. And I took it, and it was a really great chance to start the next quadrennial, and I think that's what some of the skaters here can do. Kevin Reynolds comes to mind. Make a statement, get remembered, and start a new quadrennial.
All right, let's talk about making a statement in the men's short program, which is our focus in this one, and Patrick Chan of Canada. He got his eyes open, Tracy, at the Olympic Games in Vancouver. He finished fifth, and okay, Evan Lysacek, the gold medalist, is not here. Neither is Evgeny Plushenko, the silver medalist. Still, Patrick Chan comes here motivated to make an impression.
It's all about redemption for Patrick Chan. He let an Olympic medal get away with a rookie mistake at the end of the short program. It took him out of medal contention. Hopefully he's learned from that mistake and he can build on it here. And you know, the tension was palpable with so much on the line at the Olympic Games. Here, the skaters, yes, they're tired, but they can skate free. And we've seen so many times, Kurt, at the Worlds after the Olympics, some of the best performances can happen. Patrick, hoping that's his.
And Patrick Chan, awesome. Kurt, is going to have to challenge a certain Daisuke Takahashi of Japan, who won a bronze medal at the Olympic Games. And one thing about Daisuke Takahashi, he's explosive.
He's an actor on ice, which is very rare within a competitive environment. He's a superstar in Japan, came this close to being the world champion in Tokyo. Had he done that, his head wouldn't have fit in this arena. And I think what would have happened then is what happened because of that moment is that now he's really hungry. And I hope for Patrick that Patrick's hungry too. He's going to have to be. They're essentially ranked number one and two right now. It's going to be good.
Lots of hope here at Palavella for a great men's short program. With more, here's Brenda Irving.
Scott, there's a look at Canada's second man at these World Championships, Kevin Reynolds of North Vancouver. And you know, Kevin thought his season was over after the Four Continents competition in January when he finished in third place. But Kevin got a call just a couple of weeks ago saying that he was heading to the Worlds after Vaughn Chipier suffered an injury. Well, Kevin says that if he can put together two clean performances here, this will be a very special first World Championship for him.
The phone call from the Skate BC administrator Ted Barton, and I was thrilled, and immediately I changed kind of the thought process in the day. It was kind of halfway through the day, so I started solo training later that day, but I was just really excited that I had this opportunity. So.
We know there are 48 men competing in the short program, and just 7 of them, though, have a quad planned for the program. One of them is Kevin Reynolds, and he can put up some pretty big numbers in the short program. In fact, his season best is better than his teammate Patrick Chan.
Thanks, PJ. 2 Canadians are in the field. Patrick Chan of Toronto, 19-year-old Kevin Reynolds of Coquitlam, British Columbia, 2007 world champion Brian Joubert needs a great skate here at Palavela. The odds-on favorite, however, is 24-year-old Daisuke Takahashi, who won the bronze medal at the Olympics in Vancouver and was the world silver medalist in 2007 in Tokyo.
Kevin
19-year-old Kevin Reynolds got a late call to come to the World Championships. It didn't come until March 11th when he learned of an injury to his teammate Vaughn Chipier, who had represented Canada at the Olympic Games. And so Kevin Reynolds making his first appearance at a senior World Championship. And this guy has some tools. He can jump. Can he put a whole program together?
After the national championships, when Kevin missed the Olympic team, he went on to the 4 continents and lit it up in the short program. He's got the 5th highest short program score in this field. And Kurt does it because of the rotations in the air.
So fast in the air. Here comes the quad sow. Very clean. They'll be looking at the landing of the quad sow as they always have to. But this kid, if there's lots of nicknames around the quad, he should be the quad prince.
His nemesis, the triple axel, and he popped it.
Sometimes the skater will pop it down to a double, which isn't as big a penalty as what he just did. He only singled it. That will really hurt. Scores. Triple Lutz.
To give you an idea of the points these guys can rack up, Reynolds on his quad triple combination earning a base of about 15 points. That's 5 points higher than the highest triple triple combination. But he gave it away on the axle. 8 for a triple, not even 1 point for a single axel.
Comes out of Burnaby 8 Rinks, coached by Joanne McLeod, has a teammate there by the name of Jeremy Ten, who's part of a young crop of Canadian skaters on their way up.
Program choreographed by Shaylin Bourne, and it has really helped to bring out Kevin's personality. Kind of quirky, fun.
Like his hair. I agree. I think this is a bit of a breakthrough program for him, and every skater needs one. It sort of gives them permission to start believing in themselves choreographically, stand to center ice, and tell the audience, I got a product, I'm going to sell it to you today, and you're going to buy it.
Well, he had a great free skate at the national championships in London and just missed the Olympic team. Kevin Reynolds went on to be 3rd at 4 continents in Korea. And he's been solid here at the World Championships in his first appearance. And what's he make of the short program? There's the score, 71.2, a full 10 and more below his season's best. Currently, Kevin is 2nd at Palavela.
Thank you.
Here's 2-time American national champion Jeremy Abbott. He has also won the Grand Prix final twice, but here's the line on Jeremy Abbott. He can be hot and cold.
That's right.
Jeremy Abbott of the United States, twice the American national champion.
Beautiful flow across the ice. He's got great knees. Those knees come in handy. Triple flip, triple toe. Able to use those knees to continue the momentum of the jump on a very smooth landing. Lyrical skater. Very interesting entrance to triple axel. Super relaxed in the air. And during this spin, I know what he's thinking. He's thinking, why didn't I do that at the Olympics?
Final jumping pass. Coming out of footwork, it's his triple lutz, and look at the flow and the ease going into the jump and out of it.
On a bit of a roller coaster, twice the winner of the Grand Prix final, which is the big circuit in figure skating, and then comes up with a disappointing major international competition. He was 11th at the last Worlds in Los Angeles.
He is moving from one position, one change of direction to the next so easily. This is looking more like an exhibition than competition.
At the U.S. Nationals this year, prior to the Olympic Games, he put two incredible programs back to back. And everybody who watched him perform there said, oh no, how can he do that again at the Olympics? Well, he couldn't, but Evan Lysacek did.
You know, sometimes Jeremy Abbott doesn't look at ease. Today he looked more than at ease. He was on fire.
Representing the United States of America, Jeremy Abbott.
He said he was heartbroken after the Olympic Games. I bet you that heart's a little bit mended after that short program. So smooth, technically difficult, proficient landings. Good job. Good job.
Jeremy Abbott has moved his training base from Colorado Springs to Detroit, where he works with Yuka Sato, and he had it in the short program.
Here's a look at his combination. A deep knee bend into the triple flip launches him into the air. Again, down in the knee, a little tilted on the takeoff, but easily able to control the landing.
He's a tall fellow, very, very strong, athletic, and but what he's also got is a real great sense of music and good feet.
And what I like about him, Kurt, is he doesn't telegraph his jumps. He doesn't have a long, basic takeoff. They tend to come out of the footwork, blend with the choreography, almost appearing to come out of nowhere.
Especially that triple axel. Absolutely beautiful. I think in a way, with Evan Lysacek out, that was that breathing and relaxation that you were talking about.
For Jeremy Abbott at this edition of the World Championships. His short program score is pretty big. 81.05 for Jeremy Abbott of the United States. Right into first place.
Currently in first place.
Well, if Canada's Patrick Chan is looking for a rival over the long haul, this might be the man. Just about the same age, 20-year-old Taka Kazuka of Japan. Eighth at the Olympic Games, but one thing about Kazuka, and you'll notice it, he's smooth.
his love. He will open here with a triple-triple combination. Triple lutz, triple toe.
Oh, the quality of that is so intense. He's going to like get the extra points there, and you really need to do that when you're not doing a quad combo. You need to nail it. He wasn't really worried about that triple-triple. He's probably a little concerned about this. His triple axel not as consistent. Never mind.
That was sweet.
That was awesome.
He's really making a move at the end of the last Olympic quadrennial in 2006. Takakazuka was the world junior champion.
By their talent in skating. Skating to like very cool music. All he needs is a little more confidence in the face and he'll be a rock star.
Scott talked about how smooth he is. He's got these wonderful deep knees that carry him softly across the ice. And Kurt, that's the best I've seen him skate. Focused when he needed to be and expressing the performance at the end when he had to.
On.
Watch out, world! 20-year-old Takahiko Kazuka of Japan is climbing the ladder. And he's going higher and higher.
Japan, Takahiko Kazuka.
Takakazuka trains in Nagoya, Japan with Nobuo and Kumiko Sato. And Kurt, you called him a rock star. He's got it.
We talked about the youth coming into this world and seeing the opportunity and taking it. What a great short program utilizing those fantastic Japanese knees. I don't know how they do it, but they have perfect timing up and down tempo with those knees.
You watch here on the landing, the fluid knee that Kurt's talking about. It helps softly land the jump, but gives you the momentum to take off into the next one. Look at this triple axel, perfect straight back, and watch the landing. No jarring movement, and he keeps the flow coming right from the air and brings it onto the ice.
Yep, as soon as he lights up the face.
Yes.
As soon as he brings that into his performance, this kid is gonna rule.
He's kind of a gentle, quiet kind of guy.
So he's a quiet rock star.
We need him to get loud.
A lot of people at these World Championships talking about Daisuke Takahashi. Maybe they should bring Takakazuka into the conversation because he's just posted an 84-20, way up in the stratosphere in the short program.
And 5 points better than his season's best.
A lot of points added to that triple X, triple toe combination. Good for him.
Next to skate, representing Canada, Patrick Chung.
Well, it seems like new life for 19-year-old Patrick Chan, tremendously motivated by his experience at the Olympic Games where he finished fifth. Here's what his coach, Lori Nickel, said about their goals at these World Championships.
I think we're not going to be so results-based going into the World Championships. Every athlete wants to skate their very best and then see the result. We're focused highly on what does he need to do to perform his best in that pressure cooker moment, and then we'll deal with the results.
And now Patrick Chan begins the chase for a world title.
He speaks so fondly of his edge work, his musicality. This is competition. You need to do that. Beautiful triple axel.
The most commanding presence in this short program, and the way he's skating fills the ice.
To spell over the arena with his ability to maintain momentum of the footwork and the musicality. No preparation from one step to the next, just this constant hitting you with a barrage of edge and sound.
About him having to put the mistakes of the games behind him, and he's done that in this short program.
Stormy Waters this season.
Awesome.
He had a major leg injury. He split with his coach, Don Laws. But Patrick Chan sails on at these world championships.
And Kurt, you were right. He had cast a spell on this audience. You could hear a pin drop until the end when the audience exploded.
Like
what
a
performance.
Calm fury.
It was here in 28 BC that Julius Caesar had his Romans build a military outpost. He named it Augusta Taurinorum, reflecting the Celtic inhabitants. The Porta Palatina was the gate at the northern edge of the outpost. While remains of the Roman theater are still visible, the Palazzo di Città, or City Hall, marks the original site.
That's how we do it. Yay, I'm so proud of you.
There's Michael Slipchuk of Skate Canada, the high performance director, Lori Nickel, his coach, and Patrick Chan, who is the man of the arena, the man of the moment right now at Palavela after that spellbinding short program.
And what great focus, Kurt, he showed in this performance. He was very quiet and calm when he had to be, and explosive when he needed to be.
I agree. There was this level of calm about him and steadiness on his skate. Now, even though he tripped, he hit his toe pick, actually, on the way into the triple lutz. You could see him take a millisecond to readjust and then still nail the jump. And if we're lucky, we'll get a replay of that. Looking at Lori Nichols, always nice, but this jump, just before this jump, he hit his toe pick, recalibrated, and did that. I'm so proud of him.
And you look at the landing, the precision, and then this, the edge work. You're watching the blades here deeply curving on the ice. He has this great, powerful knee that just allows him to ride those edges, and his flow and power is just matched by nobody else.
I agree.
Said he was amazed by the Olympics, caught glimpses of himself, felt that someday maybe he could dominate this sport, maybe he could make a lasting contribution. Look at that. There's a contribution. 87-8 for Patrick Chan in the short program, and there is the new leader.
Almost 7 points higher than his best short program. Boy, that was awesome.
He comes into the World Championships as the odds-on favorite. Daisuke Takahashi just turned 24 years of age, won the Olympic bronze medal in Vancouver, and has lots up his sleeve if he can deliver.
What you never want to do is give a competition away. What Patrick has done is going to make Daisuke work for this. This short program is amazing.
He hit over 90 in the short program at the Olympic Games. A little tentative though, Kurt, on that combination.
Compared to what he can do and compared to what Patrick did just now, but still pretty strong.
Here comes the triple axel. Oh,
there it
very
is.
Very nice.
There's the command that we're used to. Still one more danger move, as I like to call the jumps. Triple Lutz coming up. And with a calm and a flare, he's done. The jumping passes. Now we sit back and watch the entertainment. Audience picking up on his pace, his timing in the music.
And
clapping.
His eye contact. You talked about him being an actor, and you hit the nail on the head with that, looking right into the audience, drawing them into his movements.
So much vitality and strength. I tell kids in seminars, guys, don't get so caught up in what you're doing. Get caught up in how you're doing it. It's on.
Daisuke Takahashi was eighth in this building at the Olympic Games in 2006. He is much further up the food chain in Turin now. Well, Daisuke Takahashi of Japan, the national champion, 2007 world silver medalist, put it all on the table in this short program at Palavela.
And it was an electric performance. He got the jumping passes out of the way, got out into the audience, dragged them along with him. Sizzling, Kurt.
Well, the jumps, just watch and enjoy. We don't need to talk about that. I really want to talk about the fact that he was so into his, well, that was a little tiny bit off. Tracy, you're so picky for a dancer. But he was so into the performance, I think he even knew where the camera lenses were to look at to get the TV angles right. He was really focused on performing this short program.
And playing with the performance. Yeah. It wasn't something that was just calculated and thought out. It was playful, it was in the moment, and it was electrifying for this audience here. And this has been a hard room to work.
It has, and I think that the respect was garnered from the audience. You could see them clapping and actually moving in time with him. Brian Gilbert just walked over before he steps on the ice and congratulated him. He was motivated, so it's good sportsmanship and just shows how much they respect him.
Tough room to work, a tough road to travel for Daisuke Takahashi. Missed all of last season with torn ligaments. And then came back for the Olympic Games. And now this short program, 89.3 for Takahashi, the favorite, and he takes the lead.
Thank you.
And he gets Patrick by a couple points on the second score for the performance.
Where Patrick had that.
Well, Patrick Chan had the short program performance he's been looking for. And Patrick, just describe the difference you felt getting out onto that ice here in Torino compared to in Vancouver.
I was able to treat like this competition like a practice. I kind of put myself in the same situation I was in back in Colorado, and I've done like a simulation of a competition with my outfit. So it kind of felt somewhat back home and comfortable when I was here. And also it helps to go from a huge crowd that's sold out in Vancouver to a smaller crowd here in Torino, yet still exciting, but not the same. So it was really comfortable to control my nerves and the excitement, and I felt like I had more control over myself.
You said heading into the Olympics that maybe you had some doubts whether you could be on the podium. You said, coming here, I have no doubts that I should be on the podium. What does that confidence just do for your skating, your demeanor, both at the rink and away?
I think this is sort of my first season. I've kind of used that approach of really being confident, and I think it showed. I mean, Daisuke's been like that for a long time, so of course I think we both did very almost similar programs, and he took the lead, but I think it's that confidence, just that charisma he has extra a bit more than I do. So it'll slowly come. That's why I've got a couple years ahead of me, and it's to work on that.
Congratulations, a great short, good luck in the free.
Thank you.
Lots of support in the arena for this man, 25-year-old Brian Gilbert, the 2007 world champion from France, but this is a watershed competition. He was 16th at the Olympic Games in Vancouver, and to put it lightly, he was embarrassed by that performance.
Yeah, a complete unraveling at the Olympic Games. This man owned the quad, known as the king of the quad for a while. And his jump, the four revolution jump, is so exciting. To make it more exciting for everyone at home, this year, it's really only been about 30%, so hold on to something. Here we go. Quad combo will be the first jump. It's building up speed now. Let's go back in time. Sigh of relief from everybody, but the 5-minute warm-up, no triple axles, really clean at all. Triple axle coming up here. Saved it for the moment.
Wow, you can almost see him puff his chest out. Brian Joubert's back.
But he's got to stay focused. One more jump. It's the Lutz out of footwork.
You can see the celebration there. Great fist pump.
We've watched him over the years and his charisma and sometimes arrogance, and nobody liked to see what he went through at the Olympic Games. Welcome back, Brian.
World Championships are coming up in Nice, France in a couple of years. Joubert wants to be there, has to figure out if he's still got it. I think maybe he does.
That was for his coach.
He better be careful. He's going to enjoy himself out there. He trains that move on the treadmill.
When you're hot, you're hot. And right now, Brian Joubert, you're hot.
They agree. He has so many fans because of his charisma, his personality, and I love the way he jumps. He has this height, an explosive takeoff. What an awesome performance.
Let's face it, he's a stud. He's a stud on the ice, and people love him for that. He's an attacker, he's a competitor, he's a warrior, and you know what, not the best skater in the world, but what he brings, no one else can, and it's good to have it back.
CBC Bold and CBCSports.ca are your destinations for live coverage of the 2010 World Figure Skating Championships. From the first skater to take the ice all the way to the gala finale, you can experience it all. Go to CBCSports.ca for the event schedule and call your cable provider to get CBC Bold. Disaster at the Olympics. Triumph at the World Championships so far in Turin.
Well, he had a lot to prove, Kurt, and you could see glimpses of the old Brian in practice, and here's how he opened with his quad.
Well, I think that Brian puts too much priority on the quad, not only as a skater, but as a person. I think it's his statement. I think it's what he loves to do. And when it's working, this is what you get. You get a great, exciting performance. When it's not working, everything else falls apart. And, well, today it worked. It just worked.
You talked about him being embarrassed.
The treadmill
moved. There's the treadmill. Embarrassed. But also, he took some hits in the media from his French association. They were very disappointed and said so publicly. So, boy, this has got to feel good to have this one under his belt.
Three times Brian Joubert has been the silver medalist at the World Championships in 04, 06, 08. He won in 2007, disastrous Olympics in Vancouver, but now he's given himself a shot in Italy. Short program score for Brian Joubert, 87.7. That brings a smile to the big man's face. Currently, however, Joubert stands third.
Thank you.
After the first stage of the men's competition, it's close at Palavela. Daisuke Takahashi of Japan leads, but just by a point and a half over Canada's Patrick Chan. Brian Joubert is lurking in third, one-tenth back of Chan. Then a bevy of skaters are still in medal contention. Kevin Reynolds of Coquitlam is 14th. Here's Brenda Irving with a former world champion.
Brian Joubert came here looking for redemption. You certainly found it today in that short program. What did it mean for you to lay down a performance like that at the Worlds?
I'm very proud of me because it was very difficult after the Olympic Games. I had a lot of questions because I didn't know if I was able to compete again. But I didn't want to stop, so I wanted to do this World Championship to try my best, and today was great, so it makes me more confident, but I want to come back like I was before.
You said after the Olympics you changed your mindset. What did you mean by that, and how did it help you today?
I just want to be like I was before, so relax, no question, nice, and I think since few years I'm very nervous, and it makes the competition harder because I'm not confident, and that's all.
Congratulations on finding that confidence again.
Thank you.
He missed all of last season due to injury. Japan's Daisuke Takahashi has come back to win Olympic bronze in Vancouver and has one hand on world gold after the short program here. The men's free skate unfolds Thursday from Palavela in Turin. We'll have it, including the fortunes of Canada's Patrick Chan, at midnight local. Tonight, it's the pair's free program center stage with China's Pang and Tong leading the way. That's midnight from the 2010 World Figure Skating Championships in Northern Italy. While we have a moment, we'd like to send our best wishes and condolences to the family of our colleague and friend Ross Menzies. Ross died this week after suffering a heart attack in Toronto. He was a gifted camera operator who worked on a number of CBC productions from drama to Hockey Night in Canada. All of us at CBC Sports will miss Ross and his talent very much.